Throughout my time on planet Earth, 32 years to be exact, I've encountered people who find out that I'm the youngest in my family. I would talk to cashiers from the grocery store. My mom would tell them, "Oh yes, this is my youngest daughter. I have three other kids, but this is my youngest." The cashier would say, "Oh wow, you're the baby of the family. You must be incredibly spoiled." When I meet coworkers of my parents, they find out, "Oh, this is my youngest daughter." "Oh, you're the youngest daughter? You must be incredibly spoiled." That's what I've heard a majority of my life. I never negated that I was spoiled. I am, to this day, a very spoiled baby. I am a spoiled baby. I love it. It's my favorite thing. I even got an iPhone video when it first came out. It was a Christmas present. I got everything I wanted. I was always fed. My parents came to my high school theater shows. I had support. That's probably me in denial. I had support. Yeah, okay, I had support. But something that no one really talks about, being the youngest in the family, is the emotional stress that I had to go through. It may sound like a first world problem. I probably say it's a first world problem because what else can I ask for? I've been given everything. But being the youngest daughter, or the youngest child in my family, it came with, I adapted the need to fix everything. When my sister was old enough to go out, she had to go to work, she had school. My brother had to go out. He had work, he had school, he was doing whatever he was doing, going to theme parks. I was left home alone with my parents. I wasn't really alone, but I was home alone with my parents. It was fun. I mean, I would get to go out and pick what food I wanted to eat because I didn't have my siblings to be like, no, I want McDonald's. No, I want Jack in the Box. No, I want Taco Bell. I had that power. I'd say, "I want Mexican food. I want a burrito." And it would be easy. I'd get a burrito. But what was hard was fixing everything. I felt like I needed to fix everything. My parents would, they wouldn't fight. When I think fight, I think poo-poo, fist fight. But they would argue what seemed like to be all the time. They would get on each other's nerves. Then my dad would tell me, "Your mom's pissing me off." My mom would tell me, "Your dad is frustrating me. He doesn't listen." So I felt the need to fix it. What do you mean by fix? What do I mean by fix? I mean fix it so that my mom and dad no longer argue. I think that's another reason why I don't like yelling. When someone's yelling, say I'm at the grocery store and someone's yelling, whether they're excited or they're angry, I get spooked. Like, what's happening? Why is there shouting? There's a different side to being the youngest in the family. There's more benefits to being the youngest, but there's also negatives to being the youngest. Whenever my dad would piss off my mom, now it's funny. Now it's funny when my dad pisses off my mom. But now, before, I would talk with my mom. I would try to do things for her. I would try to fix it. However you feel like you need to fix something, that's what I would do. I already forget what it is I actually did to try to fix it. Probably I blacked it out because it was too much for me. There's pauses in me talking right now because this is the first time I've actually talked about the negative effects of being the baby in the family. So now that I know that I would try to fix everything, even when it wasn't my responsibility to fix, when I got to adulthood, I would try to fix friendships. I would try to fix someone who's failing a class. I would do what I can to help them. I would try to fix everyone, fix their choices, fix their responsibilities. That's why I felt like I have so much on my shoulders, but I don't. I'm the one who put that responsibility onto myself. So I think back to, how did that start? Why do I feel like I have to fix everything? So I go back to childhood. I go back to childhood of how it started. You know how people say, oh, how a person behaves all starts at home. That's true. In my experience, it's true. The trauma I've experienced, that I have experienced, started at home. Disclaimer, I love my parents. They are humans. This is their first time living on this earth. It's the first time I'm living on this earth. So I'm slowly learning. Nowadays, I'm a lot better in fixing things. When someone says, oh, that movie was lame. That festival was whack. What the heck did we do? We wasted our time. But if that's how you feel, then that's how you feel. I have no control to change how you feel. That would be like someone trying to control how I feel. That makes no sense. I always thought that if I can fix something, then I can make that person happy. If I can fix something, then there would be no more shouting. There would be no more arguing. But I've learned that people argue. They argue all the time. But so long as I'm not involved in that argument, then it has nothing to do with me. That is something that has taken me years to realize. It has taken me years to accept. Now, when I visit my parents, then by the off chance they are arguing with each other, I go to my dogs. I pet them. I'm not involved in any arguments that's going on around me. When the other dude, just last night, I was waiting for food at a restaurant. The printing receipt got stuck, so all the orders for the employees came out all at once. I was looking around me. A few customers were getting a little bit angry, especially because they've been waiting for 50 minutes. But I felt no need to fix it. It helps because I'm not the one working, but I can see that the employee was getting a little bit stressed, that customers were starting to get angry with him. So when it was my turn, I waited about, it was close to an hour that I was waiting for my food when they said it was supposed to be only 18 minutes. I went to the employee. I said, can you check on my order, please? So what I learned is that I cannot fix the situation that's happening. All I can do is me. All I can do is make the situation better for myself. So if I'm angry, if I'm trying to fix something, that makes me angry, especially because I know I'm an empath. So if I speak with someone to help them calm down a little bit, that does nothing. Because I'm not responsible for how someone feels. I cannot fix it. My life has been a lot smoother since I've released the need to fix everything. You don't have to fix everything. Okay, bye.